Hello everyone. Today I am going to discuss an important entity, hypertrophic olivary degeneration, with the classic case. 50-year-old male who presented with parietal tremors. We have done MR imaging of brain, basal sections. At the level of medulla, you can see the hyperintense and swollen inferior olivary nucleus. This is a flare and this is the T2 axial T2 image. And the cranial sections, at the level of brainstem, you can see the chronic infarct in the pons and caudal section of midbrain. So this is a classic case of hypertrophic olivary degeneration. So it is nothing but a transsynaptic neuronal degeneration. Any insult in brainstem and cerebellum involving the anatomical tracts can cause this hypertrophic olivary degeneration over a period of time. The cause could be hemorrhage, infarct, trauma, surgery, or a lesion like tumor. And the important thing to concentrate is the inferior olivary nucleus. Let us see what it is. So this is the axial illustration. You can see the location of inferior olivary nucleus at the level of medulla. And this is the axial MRI of brain, which is a normal inferior olivary nucleus, which is highlighted by the red circles. And this is the histopathological section. You can see the normal olivary nucleus, which is thin, smooth, and maintaining its architecture. Here you can see the swollen and edematous olivary nucleus, which is a case of unilateral hypertrophic olivary degeneration. So the important triangle whenever there is a case of hypertrophic olivary degeneration is the Guillain-Mollaret triangle. These are the two great scientists who have discovered this Guillain-Mollaret triangle. It includes the red nucleus, inferior olivary nucleus, and the contralateral dentate nucleus. So the ipsilateral red nucleus and inferior olivary nucleus and the contralateral dentate nucleus. So this is the pathway taken from a review article called The Imaging Features of Hypertrophic Olivary Degeneration. Here you can see a red nucleus in the midbrain. Through the central tegmental tract, the fibers cross, traverse through that and enter the inferior olivary nucleus. From inferior olivary nucleus, the fibers go to the contralateral dentate nucleus through inferior cerebellar peduncle. So there will be a crossing of fibers from one side to other side. And this dentate nucleus again has fibers, connecting fibers through superior cerebellar peduncle to the red nucleus. So this is called as Guillain-Mollaret triangle. When there is a disruption of this, any of these locations of these fibers or within the triangle, that can lead to the hypertrophic olivary degeneration. So there are three stages on imaging. That is, initial stage is the T2 signal hyperintensity without hypertrophy. Stage 2 is hyperintensity with hypertrophy. And stage 3 is the resolution of hypertrophy with atrophy and persistent altered signal intensity in the tracheum. These changes will occur over a period of years together in this case of hypertrophic olivary degeneration. And coming to differential diagnosis, always remember the medullary infarct, demyelinating diseases, malignancy, and infection or inflammation like tuberculosis or sarcoidosis. And look for the characteristic features. The important thing to remember is in hypertrophic olivary degeneration, there is no post-contrast enhancement and the olivary nucleus is swollen and enlarged, which has a classic appearance in hypertrophic olivary degeneration. So I have published two cases of hypertrophic olivary degeneration. One was an idiopathic hypertrophic olivary degeneration. There was no cause, there was no lesion within the this Guillain-Mollaret triangle to cause this hypertrophic olivary degeneration, which is very rare. And the other case was again the posterior circulation stroke, like similar to our case now in this video which I presented. This was a previous case which I had a similar case 2-3 years back and got published here. Thank you very much.